Hey fellow reloaders, thanks for joining. Today we're going to compare some brass, and this will be the start of my 6.5 Creedmoor handloading series. What I plan on doing is seeing if small rifle prime brass today will make a difference on our 6.5 Creedmoor. And what I plan on doing is basically demilling and reusing the same components out of the Federal Premium ammunition. These are loaded with the 140 grain Sierra Match Kings. And basically we will take all the components out of the case and swap them over into the Small Rifle Prime Brass. These are brand new from Starline. And we're gonna see if it will make a difference in our groups and also our chrono numbers. So if you're interested to see if Small Rifle Prime Brass will help out on your hand loads, stay tuned and we'll do some testing. Alright guys, to determine which route I should take for the hand loading series on the brass, I'll go over briefly how I loaded these. And basically what I really did is I just demilled the factory ammunition, Federal Premium 140 grains, and I stuffed it in, I stuffed the powder and the bullet at the exact overall length into some Starline brass. Now this is the first time I've ever actually ordered some Starline brass, and I was very surprised with the quality and the uniformity of the brass as far as overall length and the finish. The only thing I have to complain is how they basically package the brass. Of course, it's in a soft Ziploc bag, and through the process of handling, it actually dented some of the case mounts. So to make this test fair, what I ended up using was the NOE expanding plug in conjunction with the Lee expanding die. In the future, I'll go over this tool and I'll actually explain why I think this tool is actually really good, and also do a comparison on that. Basically what this does is that it expands your neck, and if you were to set it up correctly, it will also flare the case mouth to exact measurements. For instance, this was a 265 by 262. And what I'm really after for is a 262 diameter, which will expand the case mouth and the neck to 262. It's pretty accurate, as you could tell. I was able to expand the case neck to exactly 262 thousandths as it's advertised. I did this to 10 pieces of brass of Starline that we'll be using today for this test. Other than that, the overall length, I matched the overall length with the factory ammunition, and that's what I set it to. And each powder I actually weighed, and I was actually surprised that, you know, the ammunition that you pay in the stores today, over a dollar, and it's advertised to be match ammunition. After weighing the charges and actually measuring the overall length on the brass, I was actually surprised what the manufacturers call match ammunition. When we think of match ammunition, we are thinking of consistency for our rifles. And you could tell with the powder charges that I weighed and the overall length, the consistency is just isn't there. So we're paying a dollar or some plus a round, and the consistency for match, well, I can tell you right now, the groups are going to improve just by getting everything uniform in the future. So let's get on to this testing. We are set up at 100 yards today. Let me first verify zero. I'm just going to shoot three of the factory ammunition and then go on to testing five rounds each through the chronograph and comparing groups and the chrono numbers.
All right, so we shot the first five rounds factory, and standard deviation number was at 28. That's after five warm-up shots. So
those numbers aren't really looking good for factory ammunition, but the groups look pretty good from back here. So let's check this out. All right, so here is the groups with the factory ammunition, large rifle primed. You see there, that's just at MOA. Not bad. So now let's go shoot the small rifle primed, and I'll be aiming at the top left. So I was actually reading a lot of folks that are mentioning small rifle prime brass with a small flash hole. The only one that I know that makes these for the 6.5 Creedmoor is Lapua, which makes a smaller flash hole and within a small rifle prime brass. It is said to increase the primer pocket longevity, basically life expectancy, and you're able to actually also take a lot more hotter charges. You can actually load a lot hotter. I mean, the main reason why folks really like using small rifle prime brass, from what I'm reading,
is it gives a better burn rate. And that's what I'm basically after, since we're taking these 6.5 Creedmoors out to the longest range I could possibly shoot. Probably a mile, but we'll see in the future. So with the load development, we'll see what happens. The Small Rifle Prime Brass and the factory components may throw me out of a accuracy node or into an accuracy node. But like I said, the chrono numbers are going to show if there's an improvement with the burn rate. Thus, lower standard deviation numbers and lower extreme spread numbers. Other than that, like I said, the Small Rifle Prime Brass is able to take a kind of a harder load. And a lot of it's because there's more meat in the bottom of the head stamp. So that kind of makes sense. And having longer brass life is a good thing. Normally, from what I've noticed from my experience, is the first thing that goes out on the brass is the primer pocket start getting loose before I start having case neck issues. So let's go ahead and test these out. Okay, so that was the first five shots using a Small Rifle Prime Brass, and I've actually lost FPS. I lost just over 100 FPS, quite a big difference. I had two errors on my chronograph, so the standard deviation numbers were at 27.5, which is not good. But then again, if you look at the numbers that I measured on the powder charges from demilling the factory ammunition, that probably could contribute to those high numbers. But let's check out the groups. All right, so here is the group. Looks like it kind of got me out of an accuracy node. I was just over MOA. And kind of got a little bit of a stringing going on too. So let's go ahead and shoot the factory ammunition again. All right, so here's the last five shots with the factory ammunition. And that is not looking good. The chrono numbers also were showing some pretty bad numbers. 48 standard deviation, 102 extreme spread. That 2,500 FPS shot was the one that hit low, and the 28 was up here. So that's, you know, definitely coordinating with what I found with the powder charges, it not being uniform. So I'm not too happy with this ammunition. Other than that, let's check out the Small Rifle Prime Brass and shoot the last square. Alright, so I'm not really sure what to make out of this test. The chrono numbers were horrible on this one also. 65 standard deviation. Going back over my notes, these were actually the ones that had the highest non-consistency on the powder charge. So, what I could have done is I probably could have took and demilled the factory ammunition and made it more consistent with the powder charge and overall length, yada yada, but I just wanted to pretty much just test just the brass. From what I gathered out of this testing today is I am losing about 100 FPS with a Small Rifle Primed primed brass, but I believe I could catch that back up with a hotter charge. Looking at the brass itself, the brass doesn't look like it has any kind of pressure signs at all. And we are at 38 grains of whatever powder this is. Looks very similar to 4451, but cut a little bit shorter. So. I guess from here, I loaded up some ladder charges with 4451. And I'm gonna go ahead and see if I find some accuracy nodes. And I'm gonna start at 40 grains. All right, folks, I'm gonna conclude today's testing with that. The Small Rifle Prime Brass versus the Large Rifle Prime.
The data is kind of inconclusive, other than we found out that I'm losing about 100 FPS using a small rifle prime. And that the factory ammunition really isn't doing too good. You know, not to mention the inconsistency that I'm seeing when I demilled it. But with the load development done today with IMR 4451, using the Hornady 10th edition overall length 2.800, did find a couple accuracy nodes. The groups were about MOA accuracy today. So that will definitely improve with some hand loading. I'll show you guys later on in the series, so stay tuned. A couple little tools that I'm going to use, and we'll see, since now we have some fireform brass, what we could do to improve these groups and get them smaller, hopefully down to half MOA and lower standard deviation numbers. I appreciate you guys watching, and stay tuned for more load development, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Ready?
Yeah.
Bolt forward. What was that? Is that cool?
Yeah.
Want to do another one? Cool. Get the other one. Nailed it.